So I do believe that we can come to a solution using bits, lots of different kinds of options, not one size fits all kind of a thing. However, I do believe this government has to be able to show that those tax dollars, no matter where they come from, what they are, because they're all coming out of people's pockets, that they have to be used for infrastructure, spent wisely, and cannot be raided. And I think that, you know, we can look no farther than my own state. CNBC rated Indiana's infrastructure as first in the nation and consistently in the top three. One of the reasons why Indiana is rated by CNBC one of the top places in infrastructure is because we were willing to look at consistent kinds of traditional ways of financing, and we were also willing to look outside of the box at what else can we do. And we led the nation with that P3. Is P3 the answer for every single thing? Can it create an infrastructure? No, but when you look at these options and look at them together, I can tell you it paid off for our state, and our state has done phenomenal. But what our state has done is kept the bond with the taxpayer, and they've made sure that money that was put aside is not touched except for those infrastructure kind of projects. So I do believe we can find a bipartisan plan. I do have a question, Mr. Lee. When we talked about originally, and you were doing your presentation, you mentioned the freight VMT, which I'm interested in, and we've looked at that in a variety of ways as well. Can you just elaborate on that a little bit more, pros and cons on what you've seen and what your opinion is of VMT?
Absolutely. So we had developed this matrix of illustrative surface transportation revenue options. That was one of the slides. Had 38 different things on it, and over the years we've heard, look, what are the real answers? There's a lot of kind of the menu options there, but what would really work? And our board of directors, you know, they are CEOs of state DOTs, typically appointed by the governor. One former one, my boss, Brandy Hendrickson, former Indiana DOT commissioner, is sitting back there as well. But they collectively took a hard vote last year where they endorsed four specific revenue options to fix the Federal Highway Trust Fund. One was motor fuel tax increase and indexing, so for both gas and diesel taxes. Two was an upstream version of that fee, but looking at a per barrel oil level. The third was some sort of a freight user fee, given the increasing share of freight movement on our overall national network. And then the fourth one was a long-term transition to a mileage-based user fee, or commonly known as vehicle miles traveled fee. Truck-based VMT kind of straddles the last two specific mechanisms that I mentioned, but it's something that probably requires a little more investigation.
I appreciate it. And again, I think it's interesting when you look at, for example, our state as a model of the different kinds of financing options available. I do believe, especially because here we are, we're in an election year, but we're early in the year, and I think that it's goodwill on this committee right now to be talking about this so that we can put together something that the American taxpayer can rely on and that we can get away from the debt and the crisis we're running into when it comes to transportation funding. So thank you, and I yield back, Mr. Chairman.